Now let's go ahead and add another class for handling multiple selection questions. And these are going to use a checkbox. So let me find one of those. So for example, what location are you primarily taking classes at? And then you can select any number of these depending on which campuses you take classes at. So let's go ahead and go to survey.js, and I'm just going to copy and paste all this code to start with. And I'm going to call this a multiple select question. And it's going to have an array of options as well. The big difference here is that instead of radio buttons, we're going to use checkboxes. So that's one difference. And then the other difference this is going to have is that the way that we're going to gather the results up for checkboxes is to look at the checked property, whereas the way we're going to do that for radio buttons is to look at the selected property. I think that's right. So we'll find out. And I'm going to go ahead and save that and reload. And this time I'm going to use the same question as I was using before, except I'm going to make it a multiple select question. And good. So now let's go ahead and do a type in question. So that's going to be like this zip code one. What is your zip code? And I'm going to change the format of this a little bit. It's a little jammed together anyhow, but just to keep it easy. So let's call that a short answer question, because it's going to be one line. Title, text, and we're not going to need to specify anything else. And let me go ahead and copy everything up to here. And then to support the answer, I'm going to add to result an input box type equals text, name equals title, and we'll just leave the value empty for now. And then I'm going to want to say, please type your answer here. And let's go ahead and put the whole thing in a paragraph. And add a new line at the end. So there's my HTML, and I'm going to return result and close off the method. So we're going to reload, and then what is your zip code? So we'll set question 3 equal to new. Short answer question, zip code, what is your zip code, question mark, and then let's see what it looks like. Okay, so what is your zip code? Please type your answer here. I might want to mess with the fonts a little bit and make this smaller, but I think that's fine for now. So we also want a multiple select that has an other box in it. So I'm going to list these as options, and then there's going to be an other at the end. So let's go ahead and make that a child of multiple select. title, text, options. And then this is going to be the same up through here. Except instead of inheriting from question, it's going to inherit from multiple select question, and I'll call that multiple select question other. And then here, we're going to add an input box and return the result. Okay, let's go ahead and reload. And let's go ahead and find our multiple select question from before. And now we'll try, is it a multiple select question other? Oh, actually, I'm sorry, the name here should probably be other. Let me go ahead and do that. Reload. And let's see what it looks like. So cannot read property length of undefined. And that's in multi-select question. Oh, I forgot to pass in options here. So super to html.call this, comma, title, text, options. Return. Reload, rather. So let me go ahead and put a breakpoint here. And then I'm going to call that again, and we'll step through it and see what we get. So I'm in multi-select question 2HTML, which is inside of multi-select question other 2HTML. And I'm passing in title, text, options, which is an array. And then here, oh, the 2HTML doesn't take any arguments. So what it's trying to access is this options value. So I actually need to put that in the constructor when I call the constructor. So I put that in the wrong place. Now, if I wanted to step through, I can step over the next function call, step in, step. So basically step over. If you want to step into a function that's being called, you can use that. And if you want to run till it steps back out of the function, you can use this. So let's go ahead and move those parameters to the right place. It should have actually put it here. Let's go ahead and reload. Console. There. Okay, so there it is with the other box. And then let's also do multiple choice other. Copy. And multiple choice other is going to inherit from multiple choice question. And reload. And this time I'll make it a multiple choice question other. And it's multiple choice. Okay, so that's five question types. That's enough for right now. Let's go ahead and in the next video, we're going to create a section that has an array of questions in it.